Hey everyone, I'm wolfpupKG, and today, kind of ignore my background and the messy desktop and focus on the fact that we're going to be making some dogs today. So, as many of you may know, I am the texture and model person for the Copious Dogs mod, and if you've ever wondered how I make the models and textures, today, that's what I'm going to show you. So, looking at this, you can see that I have three dogs on the screen right now. I have the Shetland, and I have a pit bull that I'm mangling, and a Bernese Mountain Dog. So my initial thoughts were that since the old English sheepdog, I think I might have said Shetland, but it's the old English sheepdog, is the same size as an American pit bull, I'm taking the pit bull model and changing the size of it to be the shape of a old English sheepdog instead of the shape of a pit bull, but keeping the size of it. So yeah, I wanted to make it the same fluffiness as the Bernese Mountain Dog. That's why that's up. But I don't know. It didn't really end up being that way. I decided I could make it more sheepdog shaped by keeping the just one block thick chest, with the rest being one whole rectangle for the body. So yeah, if you just want to watch this, I'll go quiet and you can listen to some weird music that I put with my videos while you know, enjoy watching this. So yeah. Right around here, I am changing around the texture map. So that means that none of the textures for the different body parts are going to be overlapping, so I can texture the thing precisely instead of it being all weird, so you don't end up with like an eyeball on its tushy or something, you know? So now I'm taking all of the colors from a real sheepdog so that I can make authentic colors for the texture, and that's how you make it look so good. So if you try to make the colors yourself, I mean, it's kind of hit and miss with that, but when you take the colors directly from the picture, then it ends up looking a lot better in the end. So yeah, and then I blur it all together so it looks more like fur. and then I cover the whole thing in one color, and then I'll work on the accents. So right here you'll see that I'm starting to add the accents for the textures. All the white parts, I'm highlighting in green what's going to end up being white, so I know where to put the white whenever I end up actually putting it on the dog, which you'll see in just a little bit. So yeah, sit tight. So here you'll see that I'm making the white for all this, and that ended up being a little too yellow for my liking, so I added some more white in to make it look a little nicer. And then what you'll see right here is that I make a new layer, and then I put in all the white beneath the black, and then what I'll do is I'll delete the green to so it'll show all the white where it needs to be. So yeah. So now you can see that it's kind of, it looks like a sheepdog now, and all I have to do is blend all of the colors together and then add the face. So I use the blur again whenever I do this, but I only do one on it, so it still has its nice Minecraft-esque blocky fade, but it's still a fade into the other color, so it looks pretty nice, I think, in my opinion. Thank you. So right here you can see that once you add the face, it all kind of comes together, and then you have a beautiful dog. Alright, now moving on to the Rottweiler. So I think Rottweilers look a lot like the American Pit Bull in shape, and not color, but like definitely the shape of the dog. So what I did is I opened up the Pit Bull again. I didn't mean to use the Pit Bull twice as the model I based these new models on, but it just so ended up that way. So yeah, what I'm doing here is I'm shortening the tail because most Rottweilers have their tails clipped when they're little, so they have a short little stumpy tail instead of, a longer tail. So yeah, basically I just used the Pit Bull model and then retextured it as a Rottweiler. So yeah, you'll just see the texturing process again, right over here. Right here you saw a little bit of a jump in the footage. That's because I was recording this during a snowstorm, and it did it earlier once too, where some snow did something to the power to where it went off and then came back on. So I lost a little bit of the footage there, it got corrupted. But I mean, you already saw the process with the sheepdog, so you kind of know, kind of know what's up. So wrapping up here at the end, we're just putting on the finishing touches for the Rottweiler, and then that's two models and textures done. So I know I didn't really speak much on how to do all this, but, It's kind of like art where you have to practice it to learn it. So I hope this helped you a little bit, and I hope you all enjoyed. If you want to see more stuff like this, you know, please let me know. And yeah, thanks for watching. See ya.
Hey, thanks for watching.